the Imagination Institute. Hello, on your tour, you'll see how the five human senses can help capture your imagination.
Can I go too?
Absolutely not. This is one of our discoveries, the Figment of Imagination.
Yeah, I know all about the senses. There's sight, sound, smell, touch, goochie goochie go, and taste. Taste my chicken. Can I go? Please, please, please.
No, I don't want you out of my sight.
Out of sight? Okay. Come on, everybody. Here we go.
Figment, you are not to interfere with the tour.
Our first stop is the sound lab. We'll begin by testing your hearing with a series of tones. Left ear, right ear. Left, right. What? This is odd. Hello? Who is this?
It's Figment!
Figment? I thought I told you not to interfere.
But you've got it wrong, Doc. It's not about listening with your ears. It's about listening with your imagination.
Now I've completely lost my train of thought.
No, you haven't. It's over here! All aboard! Woo-hoo! Next stop, imagination! For every sound your ears are hearing, a thousand thoughts can start appearing. And each of us imagines different things from just a sound. Your mind has wings.
Continuing now, if I may, in a calm, scientific, Figment-free manner, the things we see with our eyes can control the eyes of the imagination. Let's begin by using the eye chart to test your vision. Now, all together, if you would please read line 3 and hear me.
With Figment, you can see things differently. Sure, you can see with your eyes, but imagine what you could see if you used your imagination. Follow the bouncing Figment. One spark of light can light your fancy. Your mind sees more than what your eyes see. Your sense of sight can make your fancy fly. There's more to sight than meets the eye.
I say imagination must be captured and controlled.
Nuh-uh. Imagination works best when it's set free. Just turn your imagination loose.
Research shows that smells often trigger the imagination, especially when pleasant, familiar smells come into play.
Come into play? I'd love to!
Figment, this is not a good time.
It's always a good time to use your imagination, so let the good times roll! Woohoo! You win one cent!
Figment, don't!
The nose knows.
One awful whip can send you reeling. One lovely sniff can be appealing. Your mind defines what enters through your nose. That's how you tell a skunk is not a rose.
You know, I'm sorry, but after that big stink in the smell lab, I hesitate to send you into the touch and taste labs. Perhaps I should end my open house right here.
Great idea! We'll go to my open house instead. It's much more fun. Right this way, everybody!
Figment, what is going on? You're turning this entire open house upside down!
Upside down? Now you're talking! That's the best idea you've had all day!
With just a spark of inspiration, I made my house an innovation. Imagination really comes around. But things come tied up and upside down.
can't beat them, join them. We all have sparks.
Imagination. That's how our minds create creations.
We set them free and know what they can do. Those magic sparks from me and you.
I knew you'd get it, because you've got a wonderful imagination.
I do. Oh, yes. Thank you, Figment. And so, as you can plainly see, imagination works the best when it's set free.
You said it, Doc. Imagination is a blast!
Creation, right at the start of everything that's new. One little spark.
Imagination.
And now we invite you to set your imaginations free.